All right. So just wrap up on autoimmune diseases where your body is fighting itself. There are some treatments available for that. The main way is to suppress your entire immune system and just tell T cells and B cells and your immunity not to do its job. This prevents your body from fighting off the good stuff, but it also prevents your body from fighting off a common cold or pneumonia or some kind of viral infection. This is where herd immunity becomes really important and vaccines become really important. People with an autoimmune disease or an immunodeficiency can't get vaccines like the rest of us. So by the rest of the population getting vaccines for the flu, for measles, mumps, rubella, those sorts of things, chickenpox, it keeps them safe because not everyone's body can fight it off. We call that herd immunity. If almost everyone in the entire herd, the entire community is immune, then there's no reason why a disease will spread. That's what makes this quarantine really interesting, is because by keeping us away from the herd, we can't spread it amongst ourselves and hopefully can kill this because there isn't a vaccine available yet for COVID-19. So the way we can treat autoimmune diseases is suppressing the immune system. But that means someone gets the chickenpox, measles, they can't fight it off like the rest of us. And those simple things can be very problematic later on. One thing, treatment is called anti-inflammatory drugs, antihistamines, things like that. Anti-inflammatory, remember, it's the widening of all the blood vessels that are calling in the troops. So any anti-inflammatory is saying like, okay, we're going to keep our blood vessels narrow so that we don't call in the troops because of a disease. Again, right now, the research they're trying to do for many of these autoimmune diseases is trying to find medicines that will only target the parts of the immune system attacking that body part. So diabetes, it only attacks the pancreas. Can we turn off those immune cells that attack the pancreas only instead of the entire system? We're not quite there yet, but lots of research is going into it, which is super duper cool. Okay, hypersensitivities or allergies. That's basically what this is. This is when your body recognizes a perceived threat that's really harmless. So pollen, not going to kill you, but your body sees it. That hapten, Haptens, we talked about haptens. Those are pollen, animal dander, basic little allergens that we call them. So that's a perceived threat, and your body is trying to fight it off. The problem with allergies is it causes inflammation. And it calls in all the troops. And so it ends up damaging your own body tissues in the process. And so you get the red face and all of that because of it. It's not usually life-threatening, depending on the person's allergy and severity of it. And we'll talk about those. So there's the immediate. This is where you walk into someone's house and they're like, "Do you have a cat?" And you can tell immediately because you all of a sudden have inflammation. And inflammation causes all your cells to become leaky. It leaks out white blood cells to fight off the bad stuff, but that also causes vasodilation, which causes your blood vessels to expand. And so you get the runny nose, the weepy eyes, the red inflamed face, the stuffy nose. And if you become too inflamed because of those histamines getting released from those mast cells, you could, heaven forbid, go into anaphylactic shock. This is where EpiPens come in. If someone is in anaphylactic shock, this is where there's so much inflammation, so much blood flow that it's starting to constrict airways. Everything is swelling shut and it's damaging your own tissues. This is the EpiPen goes to fight inflammation, basically to stop it from doing what it's doing, to hopefully open up everything so that you can breathe. That's usually what the thing that ends up causing it. Anaphylactic shock is rare, but it is when the allergen is in your bloodstream. So cat dander isn't going to get in your bloodstream, but a bee sting might, a bug bite could, or an injection like penicillin or something that you're taking that goes right into your bloodstream that affects you. Subacute types are mismatched.